nuclear power amid the ongoing oil and nat gas supply crunch. Pippa Stevens is here with more on the big numbers and movers. Pippa?
Hey, Kelly. Well, there's momentum behind uranium stocks after years of investors largely overlooking the space. And this all comes down to what some believe will be nuclear power's vital role in the energy transition. Spot uranium prices topped $50 in September, for the first time since 2012, according to data from UxC, and investors are taking note. The North Shore Global Uranium Mining ETF and Global X Uranium ETF are two funds that track the space, and both are up more than 20% for October. Together, these two funds have seen more than $1 billion in inflows this year. The biggest winners this month are Australian microcap names Bannerman Energy and Vimy Resources. Some of the larger players like Kazatomprom, Cameco, and NextGen Energy are also seeing gains. Now, part of the recent rally has been thanks to retail investors, with uranium mentions jumping on social platforms. But new data from VandaTrack, which tracks retail trading, shows that in the last few weeks, retail traders have slowed their buying. The firm said this points to institutional investors as behind the most recent leg higher. Kelly?
And so we've talked about nat gas and oil prices. Come on down. It's so nice to be in person, finally. Nat gas and oil, is the crunch lessening at all as we're going into the winter months?
Well, right now, weather is the name of the game, and everything will depend on how the winter weather turns out. But what we're seeing is that what's happening in Europe and Asia is pointing to a need for baseload power source, and that's something like nuclear. Solar and wind are great, but they're intermittent. They can't just be called upon at will. So nuclear is the only viable option. But of course, there are a lot of critics who really don't like nuclear.
And the U.S. is a tough country to make it work. Great in France, but here a little bit tougher slog. Pippa, great stuff as always. Thank you, Pippa Stevens, today. You can read her entire story on the uranium names by going to cnbc.com/pro. Still ahead, ticket and marketplace Vivid Seats going public via SPAC today in a deal with Horizon. Up next, we'll talk to Horizon's chairman and CEO, Todd Bailey, about what and where he's seeing opportunity. We're back in a moment.